Hi guys, and welcome back to our Stretch and Release series. Today I'm bringing you one of my favorite topics, something which I've been struggling with all through my running career. Anyways, but before I talk more about it, I want you to ask this question to yourself. When you're squatting deep, is there any tightness you feel? Do you feel any challenges in squatting deep? When you finish your run, do you feel any kind of a back pain? When you finish a long aggressive run, do you feel stiffness in the lower limbs, area below your knee? Well, it is. If you do, and the answer is yes to any one of these questions, this is the topic for you. We're going to talk about all around what ankle mobility means and how we can build better mobility in order to run better and squat deep. My first drill which you're going to work well with me are roll up. Now what I want you to do is I want you to get that roll up and I want you to place your calf right on top of the roll. The other leg goes on top, all your weight is on your heels and now all your weight is on your palms. And now from here, I want you to lift your hip up and just give me easy ankle pull-ins. So you're just bending your ankle or pulling your ankle towards you. An important thing which I picked up in my initial discussion was that if you feel any back pain. Now remember, when you're running or when you're walking, there's only one point of contact on the ground, that is your foot. So if your ankle does not have enough strength to control that, the impact on the ground, the problem always goes up, travels up towards your lower back, towards your hip. And that's where you will generally find the pain. So an important part for your runs or for your walks is to have strong ankles, at the same time mobile ankles. That was your first goal. The second one, what I want you to do is I want you to rotate your ankle. All these I want you to do about 8 to 10 times clockwise, 8 to 10 times anti-clockwise. Once you've done these three, an important one, now I want you to move your foot side to side. About again 8 to 10 times. Once you finish, repeat this with your other leg. It'll be a good drill if you do both the legs about 2 to 3 times, 8 to 10 repetitions each. Movements are going to be your dynamic movements. Drill number 1, I want you to take your foot forward and I want you to just rotate that ankle. I prefer doing this drill without shoes, but if you're in the outdoors, you can do the same drills with your shoes on. It's just that it gives me more realistic impression of what's happening around my ankle. Again, do this about 8 to 10 times on one leg and do it about 8 to 10 times on the other. That's your dynamic drill number 1. Dynamic drill number 2, I want you to lift those toes up on your heels and I want you to walk. It's going to create some strength around your shins and at the same time, you will feel that around that calf area, there's a little more stretch happening. Again, this is a dynamic stretch. These are your 2 dynamic drills. The next couple of drills, I'm going to keep them static. Remember, all our static stretches, we prefer doing it post our run or we prefer doing it when we are warmed up well. So what I want you to do is I want you to get a wall where you're standing in front of a wall. I want you to get all your weight on your heel. The foot is totally resting against the wall, the knee is completely locked out, and now from here I want you to just throw that chest forward. If you notice, my ankle, knee and hip are all straightened out and I'm just bending forward. You will feel there's a good stretch which is coming through your calf muscle. You have 2 big calf muscles here, one is the gastro, one is the soleus. Right after good strong runs, you will feel there's a lot of stiffness around the lower half, that's the soleus, but of course the gastro in the deep part still feels a little sore. We're going to work around that. That was your one stretch. The other stretch, what I'm going to do is I want you to stand with you leaning against the wall. Both my feet are a little away from the wall. I want you to get your one foot forward, and now from here what I want you to do is both my toes, or my feet rather, are pointing towards the wall. My hip is again facing towards the wall, and now from here I lock my back knee and I just keep on bending my front knee and take it close to the wall.
If you notice, my back knee is totally locked out and I am not lifting my heel off the ground. Both my heels are on the ground and I am just taking my knee, the front knee, close to the wall. That is one. The other stretch, what I want you to add on to is, this time I want you to bend both your knees and then move forward. Do not lift your heel off the ground, both your heels off the ground.
Well guys, these were your few calf mobility drills, stretching at the same time, a little more strength work around your ankles and your shin. The idea behind doing these drills is at least 2 to 3 times a week so that these little smaller areas really help you be more efficient, help you in your runs and keep you injury free. So train safe, be smart and keep following this link. If you have any questions or anything you want to know more about, just put it in the comments and we'll get back to you. Be good.